When it comes to outdoor photography, there are a lot of obstacles that you might not even think about. There's the time of day, there's people in the background probably, there's shadows being casted on everything, unless it's overcast. There's just a lot of variables. One of the big ones is wind. People get their hair done or they have a long flowy dress, and then we step foot outside and humidity makes their hair look like mine, which is a poof ball, or it makes their dress go 8 feet a different direction. You just need to think about some of those things when you're wanting to do photos outside. How do you overcome those variables? And ultimately, what do you want that picture to look like? If you want it to be soft and light and airy, then maybe we need to do it earlier in the day or later in the day when the sun is at its lowest. But if it's something that you can do more edgy, more punchy, even family photos I've done in the middle of the day, overcast or bright and sunny, doesn't matter. You just need to think about where's that picture going and how do you want it to look. Consider wardrobe, consider the sun. If the sun is 2 o'clock and you want to have this in the background, well, where is the sun? Because if the sun is in front of you, then you're gonna be squinting and it's gonna be terrible. So maybe if you want this shot and it's like up your favorite barn or something, maybe we need to do it at a different time of day when the sun is maybe behind this, and we'll come in and light it from the front so that you don't have to squint, but you get the thing that you love behind you, whether it's a waterfall, the beach, or whatever it might be. We just do it the way that looks the best for you, for your purpose.